Greetings, this is Tim again. Welcome back to the channel. I got some comments I'm going to go over first. First one is from Opti Ice Cream. Have you tried that NASA-developed 3D printed fabric? No, I haven't, and I'm interested in it. It looks very interesting. We're going to do that next. But we're not going to do it this week. I'll explain why in a second. And before that, second comment, Thomas Hermans. Looking at the quality of the benchies, I'm seriously considering canceling my Anchor Make order. The benchmarks on my Ender 3 S1 Pro look much better, and it's that not that much slower in the end. Thomas, I'd love to see what experience you've had on the Ender. I don't have any experience with that printer, so I can't, advise you, is it worth canceling your order? My personal feeling is the software here is still new. I think it's going to come up in its maturity, and we're going to get better and better prints over time. So I would encourage you to keep your Anchor Make, but in the end, it's still a value proposition that only you can make. On that note, Anchor Make notified the Kickstarter backers this week that 82 machines that were pre-ordered were shipped before the Kickstarter backer machines. Anchor Make is trying to bring these machines back, but they might not get them all. That's just the way logistics are. Accidents happen. Hopefully, they'll do the right thing. This week and next week, we are expecting about 10,000 Kickstarter backer machines to be received by their new owners, and I'm looking forward to hearing about it. With that in mind, I'm going to do a couple of really basic videos for those new owners, trying to help them get started. So today, all I'm going to do is remove the TPU that I used last week to create that TPU benchy, and I'm going to load the white PLA I typically use, and after it's loaded, I'm going to go try that NASA fabric, and I'll show you the results of that this week. I'm not going to show you the results this week. I'm going to show you next week. All right, we're back at the workbench looking at the printer. First thing I'm going to do is just check for firmware update. We're at 2.0 and there's a new firmware. So let's do the update. And we'll come back once it's ready. So that was really disappointing. That was three attempts to get the Wi-Fi to connect, but to update. And all three attempts failed. The last one took 8 minutes. So I'm sure that made some very interesting video. And the interesting thing is it had Wi-Fi here the entire time until just after that last one. So I'm gonna turn it off and turn it back on and see if I can pick up the Wi-Fi again. Doesn't look like it's going to pull up, so we'll just get into the tutorial. So we're going to go into control and we're going to extrude. And then we're going to retract. So now it's going to heat up the nozzle. And You can see there's some purple in there. I know you can't see because it's dark. But we're going to wait while it heats up to the 200 degrees, and then it's going to start to retract 40 millimeters. All right, so that took about a minute and a half to heat up. It's already coming out here. And, no, still attached, so I'm going to retract it another 40. There it goes. Now it's loose. I can pull this off. And put it in the slot. Now, according to the instructions on the manual, it's supposed to roll over. I'm going to cut this at a 45 degrees. And I'm going to start pushing it in. And ideally, I'll move this up the Z. Let's go one. Do you want to get it? Yes, we'll rehome. Alright, we'll move the Z up so it's a little bit easier to watch. And then I should be able to push this down and push this in. But what I've often found is that's not as easy as it should be. So I come back to extrude. I'm going to extrude. And it's going to take a second to heat back up. So we'll try it this way, and I can already feel it grab the filament at my fingers, but nothing is coming out. So extrude another 40 millimeters. And you can see it's starting to come out, but it's still the TPU. Now it's coming out mostly white, and we'll do another 40 millimeters. It's nice and white. That's what we want to see. So it's now extruded. I'm now ready to print something. But I've gotten in the habit about once a week do the auto level. All right, that's it. The printer has been changed over. It was disappointing that the Wi-Fi again was an issue. I'm gonna send a support request into AnchorMake tonight, and I'll even direct them to this video. Hopefully they can give us some guidance. I tried three times. It takes about 7 minutes from the time you hit update to the time that it quits trying to update. And I got the same error every time. And even now, it says it's connected. I tried it a fourth time. It still doesn't work. Hopefully there's an offline method of updating the firmware so we can get past this problem. AnchorMake, if you're watching, this is frustrating. I can't get my printer to show up in the desktop app. And I can't get it to update as you saw. There isn't an update for the desktop app. There hasn't been an update for the smartphone app. Basic things that you sold weren't working. So Thomas, maybe you're on the right track. Maybe we should consider canceling. I don't know. I'm hoping AnchorMake does good, fixes it. I'll be happy. If I get a reply I'll let you all know. I might do it as a midweek update with those new users coming online in mind. I'm hoping they have good luck with their printers. Maybe mine was just extra early and has its own issues. I'll let you know what happens. Thank you. Have a wonderful week. We'll talk to you next week.